Hi, this is your math coach, Howie Tupman, presenting What Math Should My First Grader Know? I've recorded videos in the four domains, or groupings of standards, in math for first grade. This video is the fourth of 10 videos in the operations and algebraic thinking grouping. The video is about applying properties of operations as strategies to add and subtract. If you have any questions or comments, please email me at hrtutman@gmail.com. The complete text of the standard that this video is based upon follows at the end of the video. In this standard, students learn how to apply a couple of the properties of operations to use as strategies to help them to add. The commutative property of addition allows us to switch the position of the add-ins and still get the same sum. But we're not expecting the first graders to use this formal term. They may call it switch around or turn around facts, and that's just fine. So for this example here, what we have is two yellow Unifix cubes or two yellow Lincoln cubes and nine red ones. And it shows that 2 plus 9 equals a total of 11 cubes. In this line, we've switched and we've started with the red Unifix cubes first, 9 of them, and 2 yellow. And what we want our first graders to understand is whether we start with 2 and then add 9, or we start with 9 and then add 2. In both cases, we have the exact same sum or total. And also, students should understand if we started with, say, 9 yellow cubes and let's say 2 red cubes, whether it's 2 yellow plus 9 red, or 9 yellow plus 2 red, or we switch these around. In any case, 9 plus 2 or 2 plus 9 will be equal to 11. And this is just another example, except here I've placed the Unifix cubes on a number line. We have the 2 yellow cubes, and we have the 9 red cubes. And this shows in total we have 11 cubes. And same as what we did before, let's say we switch this and we take our nine red cubes and we start with the 9 red cubes. And then we bring down the 2 yellow cubes. It's showing the exact same thing, that 9 plus 2 equals 11. If your first grader needs an explanation of this, say in terms of money or coins, you can explain that if you had 2 coins in one of your pockets in your pants, 2 pennies, let's say, in one pocket of your pants and 9 pennies in the other pocket, and then if you switched it and you put the 9 pennies in the other pocket and 2 pennies in the other one, then in either case, you have the same number of pennies, whether it's 2 plus 9 or 9 plus 2. And in either case, you'll have a total of 11 pennies. Now, once your first grader understands this commutative property of addition, or they might be saying their turnaround facts or their switch around facts, if they saw 2 plus 9, that may not be very easy for them to do, but if they know they can switch this around and put the larger add-in first and be looking at the addition problem of 9 plus 2, then they can just start with the 9 and count on 2, and it'd be much easier for them to then get their sum of 11. The other property that your first graders learn about in this standard is the associative property of addition. And once again, they're not expected to be using this formal term. They just need to know that if they're adding three numbers, that they can switch these numbers around and be adding them in any order. And this is one of the things that we did in the previous standard when we were adding three numbers. So just to reinforce this, I'm showing the example of 5 + 2 + 5. So your first grader may look at this and they may know 5 + 2 = 7, but then 7 + 5, that may not be a simple fact for them to recognize. But if they know about this associative property of addition, in other words, knowing that they can switch these numbers around in any order, they may recognize that they know 5 + 5. They may know that either as a doubles fact, or they may know that as a fact that 5 + 5 = 10, one of the 10 facts. So then if they switch this around, it will be easier for them to know that 5 + 5 = 10 plus 2 more = 12. And just to be showing these Unifix cubes on the number line and to be proving to the first grader that the numbers, the sum will come out to be the exact same, we're starting with 5 + 2 + 5 more. And if we switch this around, so if we take our two blue cubes out, and then we move our yellow cubes over, bring our blue cubes down, what we're now showing is we went from 5 + 2 + 5, and now we're showing 5 + 5 + 2. And in both cases, we had a total or a sum of 12. If you're interested, here is the complete standard that this video, Applying Properties of Operations as Strategies to Add and Subtract, is based upon. Apply Properties of Operations as Strategies to Add and Subtract. Examples: if 8 + 3 = 11 is known, then 3 + 8 = 11 is also known. Commutative property of addition. To add 2 + 6 + 4, the second two numbers can be added to make a 10. So 2 + 6 + 4 = 2 + 10, which is equal to 12. Associative property of addition. Students need not use formal terms for these properties.